Johnny, today marks 2,939 days of loving you. I sometimes imagine reliving those days in order to look back and feel what it was like getting to know you, knowing what I know about us now. It was back when we were preparing to leave our hometown and promised each other that we wouldn't hold each other back from what may occur with school and other relationships. But like magnets, we keep running back to reconnect, and the story goes on. What I take away from those days was that we had no intention of creating this. It was never forced or manufactured. I believe we have found love in its purest form. We are now allowing it to manifest into marriage. When we leave here today, I will continue to love you and cherish you as I always have. I vow to keep an open mind and inspire yours to open as well. I promise to keep you comfortable, both emotionally and physically, especially when it comes to football games. When you need your Romo jersey washed and a 12-pack in the fridge and no distractions, and maybe a shoulder to cry on when they lose, and especially someone to cheer with you when they win. I promise to always seek out our next adventures with you, whether it would be planning our next trip or even once for dinner tonight. I promise to make you smile when I wake up in the morning to kiss you goodbye for work and then rush away because I'm running late. Things won't always be usual, fun, or bright, but I will be there for you in times of despair, sadness, and grief. I will listen to you and learn with you how to dance in the trenches of life and to see the light in any hardships that we may face together. Today, Johnny, I promise to never walk out on everything that we've uncovered between us. I promise always to stand strong by your side and continue to work at the mold of our future because it's a masterpiece. And today I give you all of myself as I am here and now, and accept you for all that you are here and now. Johnny, I promise to make you a proud husband who falls asleep every night next to his best friend. I love you.
I've always had a keen sense of curiosity for philosophy that you help perpetuate. While life has tried to make me cynical, stern, and all too serious, you keep me witty, sane, and optimistic. And your caring, anxious heart of gold has my interest piqued. A great philosopher once said, "When marrying, ask yourself one question. Do you believe that you will be able to converse well with this person into your old age? Everything else in marriage is transitory." We can make all these promises, and I could promise to always watch meteor showers with you, or always scratch your back before bed. And I do, I promise I want to give you the world, the moon, the stars, the universe. But today I want to make a vow to you that I know I can keep. I vow to always communicate with you. I know I can get distracted or be stubborn, but you're always going to be a part of my thoughts and a part of my mind. We have so many new experiences ahead of us, new thrills, new fears, new passions, new opinions. And in a world where everyone judges everything you say, I know I can always confide in you. I vow to always listen to you. Your day, your week, your month, your year. I hope you never have a bad one, but I'll be there for all the ones that go wrong. I want to hear about all of them. And you know, I'm always going to try and find a solution to your problems, even when you just want someone to empathize. But no, it's only because I want you to persevere in everything you do. Just know that I'll always be your support for happiness. You are my best friend, and I always want to know how you think.